if I thought that in some way he was either ignoring or undermining the national interest. And I never saw that in any of those three men, even though, as I say, I disagreed with all of them on something.
In an interview with CBS, you're asked about politics and a viable woman candidate if it's not you. Mm-hmm. And you replied, quote, "Politics is so unpredictable. Whoever runs has to recognize that the American political system is probably the most difficult, even brutal, in the world."
Yeah.
You've been to more than 100 countries.
I have.
Most brutal?
Well, not in a beat you up sort of sense, but in an absolute marathon, running the gauntlet day after day. Most of our fellow democracies around the world, many of which are parliamentary, they choose a leader from among the elected officials who represent a constituency, but not the whole country. That's not where they're elected from. Many have time limits, whether it's 60 days, 90, 120 days, so their campaigns don't go on for years. Many of them don't cost anywhere near as much. We require our candidates to raise all that money. Certainly a lot of them have rules that prevent other money from flowing in, influencing. I mean, you list all the differences. Now, I'm quick to add that
I guess just people perked up with brutal, I suppose.
Yeah, I think that comes from experience, because when I ended my 08 campaign, I was exhausted, I was drained. It was quite an experience. But I'm quick to add that, you know, part of it is we have a different idea about free expression, about the role of money in politics, as the Supreme Court has recently said. And we're a big, complex country. And so getting through that gauntlet to be one of the nominees to run for president requires a lot of stamina.